Miwa Hatamoto to serve. Shovel serve with a bit of backspin to start things off. Polkanova has a really wristy flick, so serving into the forehand is a pretty good tactic from Miwa. Does it again, and she stays right on top of the ball with the attacks. Good start from the cadet. There he is, Zhang Jie. Nice redirection there. She's using her brother's signature blade. Maybe it won't be so long before she has her own. Hatamoto name will be ringing around halls for a long time. And look at this. She's yet to drop a point. Bit of fortune there, but read the serve. Pins Polkanova in the middle there with the push and then goes into the backhand. Tall players have a very big crossover point to hit into, so you can get a more passive ball from them and then play more direct. Great spin from Polkanova, gets the first point there. This is going to be a hard match for both players. So far, Miwa hasn't made it look too difficult. Nice there, right in the corner from Polkanova. She's a fluid player. Smooth strokes. Balanced herself nicely there. That is exceptional play. She flicks the loaded reverse pendulum and then puts the icing on the cake. 6-2 to Miwa Hatamoto. Just remembered a video that I saw online of Tomokazu playing against his sister in a few points, and he was kind of taking it really easy, but I imagine she could give him a really good game now. They actually took a title together in mixed doubles, one of the contenders last season. But since then, Miwa has been selected to play alongside Sunsuke Tagami. Three up. I mean, she hasn't been selected for the World Championships in singles, maybe because she's a little bit younger and they've gone for the players that have been in the team for a bit longer for chemistry.
19.
But for me, she's already good enough to play for Japan at events like the World Championships. If she can continue her form through, she might be the youngest Olympian table tennis in Paris, but she's got a few to kind of overtake in the rankings. 7 game points. I mean, Polkanova is a really tricky player to come up against. She's left-handed. There's not many left-handers. She's one of the best, but look at this. 7 game points. Well, that's a way to save one. She punches through that serve. Guess there wasn't a lot of spin on it. Easy pickings for Miwa Hatamoto, 11-4 in the first in the sport, and she is.
Love one.
When you've got long limbs, it's really hard and tiresome to recover after you play a stroke in such a swift adversarial sport. That's why Polkanova is an exceptional case, because you don't really see many players this tall play table tennis. Of course, there have been some anomalies, but usually not the case. Good switch. Compact play. Really taking the game to Polkanova.
One, two.
Loads of backspin on it. The stamp is so loud. And why would a player stamp? Because it masks the indication of how much spin you put on it. Look at this. 6 of the last 8 points to Haramoto.
Two,
imagine being 14, you're traveling the world, still at school, seeing all these places, meeting all these people, getting worldwide exposure.
Four, two.
You could argue there's less pressure on her at this age, but I don't know. To infinity and beyond, it balloons off the top edge of the racket. Miwa has guaranteed here at least a 2-point cushion. Coach Nakazawa is optimistic, but not too much so.
2-6.
Look at the service success as well. 70% of the points she started with a serve, she's won. So much control and then a punch. What hasn't she got in her inventory? Good there from Polkanova, that was nice. Knew she needed that one, but she's 4 points down against serves here. Wow. That shovel just contacting right near the edge, and that's how you produce more spin on your serve. You don't want to hit the ball on the center of your rubber because you won't produce as much.
3-9.
This is a service masterclass from the 14-year-old. Two away from going 2-0 up. Look at how it just kicked even wider there. And even despite the lateral reach, still couldn't get to it, Polkanova, and make a shot.
4-9.
Off the net, she comes across the side of the ball to guide it. This is unbelievable. Seriously unbelievable. And she's getting dismantled.
Love one.
Good block there from Polkanova. Don't know what the players came into contact with there. I mean, I know it was the table, but something rattled. I think maybe it was the string on the neck clamp. A bit more quality on the serve. What determines quality? Probably lowness over the net, the length, the spin, and the deception.
Love four.
By deception, we mean disguise. And
one,
there,
four.
There was some deception. similar kind of service motion, goes really fast down the line. Surprise factor really high, and it has to be when you're serving long at this level, otherwise your opponent will just hit a winner past you straight away.
5-1.
Even though she's lower ranked to me, or I'd say she's got the better of the wins between these two, she's already beaten the likes of Liu Weishan and Chen Tianyi. Polkanova hasn't really beaten that level of Chinese player before.
5-2.
But she has beaten Du Hoi Kem, players like Sato, Nietzsche, Yang Haun. She's had some great wins, Polkanova.
4-5.
That serve's caused so many issues, the shovel into the forehand. Polkanova isn't so confident with the push and touch. Because you're coming around the side of it with the serve, it's not as obvious what you're doing to the ball.
Five,
look at this, a double bouncer.
Time out. 5-6.
It's a few points in a row here. She lets the ball drop meanwhile to get more dwell on the top spin. Again, slower, heavy spin. She's never beaten a continental champion. She'll already be able to tick the box here if she beats Polkanova. 7 of the last 8.
11.
The streak 8 continues. 8 of the last 9. 3 away.
5-9.
You can never say who wants it more, but I think there's certain players who look like they're more willing to lose. And it's those players that can play more freely. You have to be ready to lose if you really want to take it to your opponent. You've got to accept that before you even start playing. A flat block.
10-6.
She's young enough, well, younger than people who do their GCSEs. And she's already passing examinations like this. 4 match points. What a finish! Take the box. She has beaten the European champion.